Guys and gals, Hurricane Ida is going to be a game changer. Hurricane Ida is pissed off, and she's coming. The latest update has her at 80 mile per hour winds, category 1, but now projected to be a powerful, life-threatening category 4 when it makes landfall. And believe me, in the Gulf of Mexico right now, the water is so warm, so deep, that you cannot rule out a category 5. Before I even start this video and get into the graphs, if you are in the northeastern quadrant of this storm, and that is central Louisiana, just off to the east, New Orleans, Slidell, even into Gulfport, Mississippi, you need to think about evacuating, and you need to think about that now. Believe me, in 2005, I was right here. Hurricane Katrina hit New Orleans, and it devastated Dolphin Island, number one. Number two, storms of this magnitude have more raw power than you could ever imagine. Just last year when Hurricane Sally hit and I was filming that, there was more power in the air than that you could imagine. It was almost humbling. Some light rain just began falling. But if you're watching this video and you think you are going to be near that right front quadrant of this storm when it makes landfall, get out now. This storm will go down as one of the biggest storms in history, or this century, in my opinion. But, you know, I'm not a pro at this. I've just done it since I was young. It's kind of a hobby. But this storm has a setup to be a game changer. Let's look at this thing. Again, this rain behind me has nothing to do with the current storm. This is just some of the normal days here in Alabama in the afternoon. But the ground saturated. This storm's coming. And the storm this size can span distances of, say, from... let's go Louisiana all the way to midway through the state of Florida. That's how wide this storm can be. There's going to be impacts felt a long ways away, but I can assure you 100 miles to the east of the center of circulation of this huge, huge setup of a storm, it's going to be dangerous. Think about evacuating now. Let's look at this thing and see where we're headed. I figured I'd tease out a little rainfall. This rainfall doesn't have anything to do with the storm, obviously, but once Hurricane Ida comes through, I'll be here. Again, if it's a Category 4, I will send my wife and 5 kids, well, 4, one's in college, but I will send my 4 kids and her elsewhere, but I have equipment here and I'm prepared for it. I've got helmets and batteries and food and preparation kits and first aid. I'll stay here and video it, but it gets really interesting, to say the least, right here. That tree gets bowed over. It's awesome. All right, the latest update, or updated graphic from the National Hurricane Center. If you just look at the width of the cone, you think the cone shifted to the west. It just got smaller. The current center of the cone hasn't changed. Because the storm is inching closer and closer to making a landfall, at least in the United States on the northern Gulf Coast, then the cone shrinks because there's less variables for the algorithms and the computers to put together. So the models tend to get really tight together this close out. And guys and gals, we're talking landfall 2 p.m. Sunday, which is like 36 hours away. This storm right now just bumped up to 80 miles per hour, and the barometric pressure dropped from 987 millibars to 985 millibars relatively quickly within the past 2 hours. And is forecasted now to make landfall as a powerful and life-threatening Category 4 hurricane. I don't want to rule out Cat 5. I don't want to rule out Category 5. There's nothing to inhibit this storm to becoming a Category 5. Maybe it gets so strong where there's an eyewall replacement and it kind of wobbles a little bit and coughs up a little bit of steam. But it will make landfall as a Category 4. But the difference between a Category 4 and 5 is a moot point. You got to get out. Believe me, I've been there. You think you want to stay. You think you want to ride it out. And then it all of a sudden it hits you, and then you get scared for your life. Again, I do this as a hobby, but get out if you are in the line of fire of this storm. I will even get out here in Dolphin Island if it wobbles any to the east, or at least my family will. I will remain. Let's look at some other things and get a little bit more into this. I'm getting excited. All right, I wanted to use our local radar for an example for this next little segment here. Again, the last video, if you just glanced at the cone with kind of your open eyes, you would think that it showed the track shifted to the west, because the cone earlier kind of came along closer to where I am, the blue dot. But that's not what happened. The track is still right down the middle where it was before. You see now that it's forecasted to be a Cat 4. I think it's not out of the question to be a Cat 5. But the cone just shrank in width because it's closer to land at this point. Anyway, within 36 hours, if this track remained right on course, okay, let's put the center coming... Oops, oh man, I almost messed everybody up. Sorry about that. But let's put an X right here on the coast of Louisiana where it came ashore, okay? The worst of the storm is the northeastern quadrant. So anybody, now mind you, the most devastating aspects of this would be right around a center, right? There's no escaping that. That's devastation. That's death. If you think you're going to be in this close proximity to the right front quadrant of this defined eye when it comes across, it will be a defined eye. You must get out. You won't survive it, and no one will be able to come and get you. But the impacts of the storm, of a storm that will cover the width of from the Texas line to halfway through the state of Florida, will go out 100 miles or so. So anyone in this general area is going to get significant impacts. So I heard someone saying a little while ago at the gas station we were filling up that, well, I may not need to fill up now because it doesn't look like it's coming here. Think again. Again, Hurricane Katrina hit New Orleans. It was a little bit closer to New Orleans, at least in terms of landfall based upon this current track. And it just devastated here. So understand, don't take this one with a grain of salt. The impacts are going to be felt far and wide on this storm. And anywhere in between the immediate eye wall of this storm, out about 100 miles. You have to brace for it. All right, this is the latest set of models, or the ensembles, for some of the models. Now, the only reason why I'm showing this, it's so close. The models are kind of out of the window in a way, but the models, at least the lines that are drawn on these models, are the center of circulation. So again, the cone on the previous segment, you know, you saw the center of circulation was in the same spot, but some of these models still predict this storm may just come right on up to the eastern side of that cone. Now, does anybody remember Hurricane Camille, 1969? Does anybody remember Hurricane Frederick, 1979? If you look at the historical patterns of storms that are Category 4 and Category 5 historically, they have the same trajectory. They start very, very low in the Caribbean. They clip the Yucatan, or they kind of go through that kind of channel of really smoking hot water, or they clip the tip of Cuba, and then boom, they race up. They don't have time to ebb and flow. They just have time to strengthen, and then bam, they make landfall. So I'll change the color of the pen here. Let's say the center of circulation comes across right in the middle of that cone there, okay? Mike Etterer in Mississippi, Ryan Mason in Mississippi. Watch out, guys. You're right there. Here in Dolphin Island, we're this little island you can see right below that red scribble. We're right here. So 100-mile radius from that, we're in that. So, again, I can't overstress the fact that this is a serious storm. The right front quadrant is going to bring some pain, and it's going to bring some suffering. So if you have an opportunity to get out, do it. I told my wife a moment ago, and my four kids out of the five of them that I have in the house still, is I will put you guys on the mainland across the way, and I'll ride it out here because, again, I enjoy it. I'm willing to stick it out no matter what. I did it here through Sally. The roof caved in on me. We had to leave, and I kept them here through that, and I felt bad for it ever since. It wasn't an entertaining time for them. So I can only imagine it will be similar to Sally, but not in terms of length. I get the landfall. The eye of Sally went basically right over us, at least the western side of that eye. But this storm is so much more powerful than Sally. You know, Sally was 110, made landfall, just teetering Category 2, 3, right in there. This storm's going to be a Cat 4, in my opinion. No one said it. I don't think anyone said it, but I'm saying it. I think this is going to be a Cat 5. And Katrina was hovering around that 4-5 and made landfall in the same point in time and absolutely devastated here in Dolphin Island. I've lived through it. I've seen it before. So I'm going to talk about it here because I'm going to use this platform to tell you. It can be really, really intense and really, really bad. And if this storm is anything like Katrina, that's making landfall at the same point in time, like nearly the same date in 2005. Remember history. We must remember history. We don't want that to happen again, and it very well could. And I think this time it could be worse because we have COVID and we have everything else. Be prepared for this one, guys. One of my favorite graphs to look at is the intensity guidance model. Right on this, you see two variables. On the left axis, up and down, you see wind speed. And on the lower axis, I'll scroll it up for you. Let me turn this pen off. On the lower axis, you see hours. So every 12 hours moving forward. So time and wind speed. None of these say that this storm will crest a Cat 4, okay? The eerie thing is all of them, for the most part, the meat of them, the bulk of them, say it will definitely be a Category 4. But since none of the models have the courage to tell it like it is, in my opinion, I'm calling it now. This will be a Cat 5. This will be a Category 5. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make my own little model on here. So here's my dot. That's the JPD at 5K tennis model. I think it's going to be a Cat 5. I don't know what's going to inhibit it. There is not really any shear at all. The high pressure to the east has kind of dissipated a bit. The water that it's traveling through is the warmest in the Gulf and the deepest in the Gulf. In other words, the worst possible channel of water for this storm to travel through in terms of gaining strength, it's traveling through. So I think it's a Cat 5. I do. And I don't think there's any way around that. But Cat 4 for sure. What I'm going to do is go through a couple more things and end this video and get ready for a very interesting 24 to 36 hours starting when we all get up in the morning. I hope everybody's ready. Get the comments, get the chat going. Don't forget to hit the like button. Don't forget to share it if you have anybody that's in this particular area. And please hit the subscribe button. It means a lot. I really enjoy doing the videos. Thanks all you guys for subscribing and commenting with me. I sometimes have some of you come down and visit and come meet me. I think that's great as well. Just don't unsubscribe when I do tennis videos. Just ignore the tennis videos if you don't like them and stick with the weather videos. Anyway, let's look at a couple more things and wrap this up. One of the things I'm going to end with is just a picture of the infrared radar. This is current. And this is a storm that shows nothing but signs of intensification. So we have a defined center of circulation. You can see there was a little bit of a developed eye there, or starting of a little developed eye. It kind of met this western side of Cuba, dissipated a bit, but the wind field still continued to strengthen. And this storm now is moving on its way into the Gulf of Mexico. One thing I do want to point out, and this isn't the greatest news in the world either, is that when this storm approaches the northern Gulf Coast and makes landfall, some of the models have this storm slowing down. What does that mean? Well, it means the rain event and the wind event will be prolonged. New Orleans, I think, can handle up to 5 inches of rain until the pumps work about halfway. I think you have to check my math on that. I'm not sure. I know a lot of you from Louisiana that watch these videos would know better. But I know after 5 inches of rain and then after X and Y amount of hours, I think another few hours, I think the levees aren't or the pumps aren't guaranteed to keep everybody out of the bowl that is the New Orleans, Louisiana area. You know, you got Pontchartrain on one side, the Mississippi River on the other side. You got the Gulf of Mexico on the other side. So New Orleans is in that proverbial fishbowl. I hope everybody enjoyed the video. I really enjoyed doing them. And sometimes, I just speak off the top of my head, so pardon the sometimes. But anyway, I will see you guys bright and early tomorrow. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit the like button. I will get out tomorrow. Maybe I'll drive around Dolphin Island a little bit, go to the water. Maybe you guys give me some ideas of where you would like to see. And anyone that's here, don't think that this storm, because it's making landfall in Louisiana, that and that's not ruled out, by the way. You know, there's an old saying, when you follow weather, at least hurricanes or typhoons or cyclones, and you see the forecast cone on top of you like a week out, you can almost assume that it's not going to land there. And that's what makes me a little on edge here. And the only way it can err is to the east. So I'm not 100% sure that the current landfall, central Louisiana or New Orleans, is true.
I don't know if I'm right or wrong, but I feel a little uneasy about this one, and I think we may get a more Mississippi landfall, which would give a couple of my friends a real bad day, Mike and Ryan, and bring a lot of devastating impacts here to Dolphin Island. Take care. I'll see you in the morning. Let's get the chat going. I want to talk all night about this, guys, so give me something to talk about. Let's talk about Ida. Anyway, I'll see you in the morning, but I'd love to chat all night. So let's get it going. Take care, and I'll see you mañana. Can't wait. Let's go. Come on, Ida.